Yeah, so we both used the acoustic guitar a lot for getting our songs sort of to give birth to the songs. So, because songwriting has many stages for us. It's the first you have a simple melody and very simple chords, and when you have that, from there you can go and make elaborate arrangements. But the way we work is usually we start with a very, very simple structure. And for me personally, a lot of times just a simple chord. Like if I find a chord that sounds good to me, I'll get a melody in my head and then, you know, work my way from there.
Sostanzialmente dice che nello scrivere le canzoni lui appunto questo approccio molto semplice, parte proprio quindi dalla chitarra acustica senza troppe sovrastrutture, che poi lascia una seconda fase di arrangiamento eccetera, e parte molto spesso proprio da un semplice accordo, e da lì gli viene magari in mente una melodia e inizia a lavorare con questo tipo di approccio, quindi molto molto easy. What about you?
For me it is quite similar, but I sometimes start with a melody in my head. Maybe when I'm just driving or taking a walk or something, then I don't always carry a guitar like this guy, but I always have a phone or something to record it with. And when I was younger, I remember once I was 11 years old, maybe, I was with my parents at a house somewhere in the, on the countryside, and I had this great idea to a song, and I had nothing to record it or to write it down. They were outside barbecuing. So I snuck out and took one of the coals and wrote down the song with a coal on some piece of paper that I found. So sometimes it's not very convenient, but you have to use what you have, I guess.
E anche per lui invece l'approccio non è sempre così, a volte lui parte da una melodia che gli viene in mente così immediatamente dal nulla, e quindi la registra con cellulare o con altre cose, insomma. E si ricorda appunto una volta quando era bambino, 11 anni, che non aveva nulla per registrare, allora c'era nel barbecue, ho preso un pezzo di carbone e ha scritto giù la canzone, insomma. Ok.
Mm-hmm. And for most of the like more soft songs, like ballads and stuff, I write a lot on the piano. Because for me that's very nice. I can have one chord with one hand and then play a melody with the other.
Pianoforte spesso scrive anche appunto che è molto comodo avere un accordo e da lì fare la melodia con l'altra mano. Insomma.
That's interesting because you're first and foremost a guitarist, but you write a lot of the core ideas for songs on piano. I'm a pianist and I write all my first ideas on acoustic guitars.
Quindi insomma, lui è un chitarrista e scrive sul piano, lui invece è un pianista e spesso scrive sulla chitarra. Insomma.
And we were discussing the other day why this is, and we came to the conclusion that, let's say, you're a guitarist,
yes,
and you know your instrument very well, and then when you want to compose a song, to play something that you've not played before, to get different ideas, you have to think different than you usually do, and then it's good to take another instrument in your hand, and that makes you, that gives you different ideas, your mind starts to think in different patterns, and you end up doing things you did not maybe plan to do, and that could be the seed of a good song. And then when you have captured the song, the basics, then you go back to the instrument you know very well, and then you can do the arrangements.
Sostanzialmente dice che se componi sempre utilizzando il tuo strumento, che sicuramente conosci molto bene, però magari ti può limitare a livello espressivo. Utilizzare invece uno strumento che solitamente non usi, non è proprio il tuo, ti può dare dei suggerimenti, delle idee in più, nuove, un po' di ispirazione, che poi puoi riportare sul precedente, cioè sul tuo strumento e perfezionare.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The next song we're gonna play is called Soulmates. And I wrote that actually on the piano a couple of days after my dad had passed away. So I was filled with strange emotions. I sat down with the piano and just put my hand somewhere and just started playing, and oh, something's happening. So I pushed the rack and recorded.
Questa canzone sostanzialmente l'ha scritta dopo pochi giorni che era scomparso il padre. Si è seduto al pianoforte e si è creata questa atmosfera magica, per cui immediatamente ha acceso il registratore perché capiva che c'era qualcosa di bello in corso.
Sing. children all grown. Family, you will be missed. It's been a long time, and I'm now waiting to die. I must say that I'm a little scared. But you say, don't worry, it will be okay.
We had a great day in Rome yesterday with our hosts Alessandro and Alessandro. So Ragnar and Alessandro. And we came to a conclusion, me and Ragnar, that we really like Italian, the way it sounds. It's so musical and full of melody. So we started asking, how to say this, how to say this. This is called Capo
Tasto.
You use that a lot.
The capo?
Mm. Yeah, because I'm a piano player, so I like to, I don't know why. But it also, you know, of course, good songwriting tips. Mm. If you're used to playing in open this position, you have the chords, you're familiar with them. Just by putting a capo in any place in the neck,
yeah,
can give a different sort of feeling.
It's like a new instrument.
Yeah. So, I just love when I write. So the next song is called Northern Lights.
Aha!
And it's a song we wrote specifically for this tour, for the Gela VGS tour. Northern Lights. Have you seen Northern Lights? Aurora Borealis.
Aurora Borealis. Avete vista?
Once.
Yeah, okay.
You know
it. They're not always out there.
Yeah, exactly.
We have a lot of it in Iceland. So this is actually an Icelandic, well, it's sort of a trademark for Iceland, I think, the Northern Lights and Iceland, Northern Norway.
Mm-hmm.
So this is very dear to us, the Northern Lights. section on the world list. Outburst, hidden from infection of the world we gained. Hiding my stains of red wine on the table. I'm still not able to connect the dots and see it all through you. Reflected in the wine again. If you want me to, I'll disappear. Still, I'll follow you to God knows where. No longer alone and never scared. The northern lights will. Northern lights will guide me home.
Yeah, next song. It's song called Urges. It's from an upcoming solo album. It's funny, I play in Iceland through the years. I played mostly heavy rock, metal as a front singer of a metal band. And then I started touring with my band Ársti. It's actually an indie folk band. And it's interesting, like I did not end up where I sort of thought I would end up musically. Mm-hmm. Start out really heavy, and then touring 30 countries with an indie folk band, and now I'm making my first solo album, and it's very fragile, very soft acoustics.
Mm-hmm. It was the same for me.
Yeah.
For my solo album, the Circle. Yeah. I had actually the reason for my change was that I had enough of doing the metal. I thought there must be something more. Must be something more that I can do than just scream all the time.
Well, I think songwriting is like you may have an idea or an ideal you want to go to, but that might be an artist that inspires you, but you're not that artist, so whatever comes out of you is always going to sound like you do. And the more you embrace it, the better the songs, the more freely the songs come, so when you don't try to steer the songs. And when I learned that, the songs came more easily because I was not trying to lead them, I let the songs lead me instead.
Sì, sostanzialmente stanno parlando un po' di come si è sviluppata un po' il loro modo di comporre, eccetera. Tutti e due hanno un po' iniziato appunto dalla band metal rock, E poi si sono un po' spostati su generi un po' più intimi, lui un po' più sull'indie folk, lui su anche il suo progetto solista molto più appunto intimo, perché appunto si diceva a se stesso che insomma voleva sperimentare anche cose diverse piuttosto che urlare sempre, come dicevano. E parlando appunto poi dell'approccio alla composizione, diceva anche del discorso che spesso si tende a seguire un ideale, a seguire o copiare qualche artista, eccetera. Invece a un certo punto è stato proprio completamente deciso di smetterla, di seguire questa cosa e di scrivere ciò che gli veniva da dentro, quindi praticamente fare sì che fosse la canzone che lo guidasse e non il contrario, quindi esprimersi in maniera molto libera e totale. Quindi questo è stato un po' il percorso che hanno fatto e al punto dove sono ora.
È il punto?
Il punto, the point where are you now?
In Rome we say er punto.
Er punto. Abbiamo insegnato anche il romano.
Bravo.
Bravo.
Hai visto?
Bravo.
Un milanese che gli insegna il romano.
Urges.
Urges.
You'll always be my girl. What I don't deserve. Saw the world with different eyes. Why the focus every time we cry? Full of love and lucky words. We never talked and never really tried. Oh, try. Still I feel you're the one. Crying as we fell asleep, we wake up to a new and brighter day. Full of all the lucky words, so many things that we could never say.
It's really funny when you come from a heavy metal practice and you sit down on an acoustic guitar and this comes out. It's like, where did that come from? Who's this guy in the mirror? But yeah, that's interesting. Like, it keeps you, as a songwriter, it keeps you you surprise yourself sometimes. Mm.
For me also, I think it's very important to write different types of music, because when you're writing soft stuff like this, it allows you to go into directions that you cannot necessarily go when you're doing heavy metal. But, or you would not think of going in that direction when you're doing heavy metal. Mm. But you go even further and further into this fragileness, mm-hmm, and softness. And then you think, aha, well, there is something in there that I didn't know before. And maybe I could use that in the heavy metal or whatever, and vice versa. Mm-hmm. You use the extremes for the metal, screaming in a ballad. It's not a lot of people who do that. But if you've been doing heavy metal for a while, then you could think of screaming in a soft ballad.
Riguardo l'approccio alla composizione, appunto, per fare queste cose un po' più soft, un po' più intime, a volte anche sorprendente per loro stessi, quindi si accorgono di esplorare dei territori, di arrivare a dei punti che con heavy metal sostanzialmente non riescono a raggiungere, quindi sono molto sorpresi, ed è quindi una sperimentazione verso l'estremo.